My name is Phil Wackels. I'm the Assistant Director of Public Works. I work out of the City Garage. Also with us tonight is Stephen Yonke. He's the City Engineer and Director of Public Works. We also have several counselors with us tonight. Counselor Baker, Counselor Howland, Counselor Murray, and Counselor Rasmussen. And also, also Mayor Rasmussen. Yep. Oh, and Counselor Minow, or Counselor Brooks. I didn't get Brooks. I'm sorry about that. And then our City Manager, David Todd, is in the back of the room as well. And I think that does it for introductions. You can approach any of us after the presentation and ask questions or give input. And again, thank you, counselors and other staff, for attending tonight. The Central Tower has reached the end of its useful life. In 2012, we did a study. Bolton and Mink helped us to look at what did the future hold for the Central Water Tower. And the results of that study were it was still safe, it could still be used, but it would not be cost beneficial to do so. The time has come for us to tear the water tower down and start over. The service life for a water tower built today is at least 100 years. So really, we're laying the groundwork for our water storage needs downtown for the next 100 years. So this is an important decision, and one that I'm glad that you are all here to learn more about. Again, with that study, there was several concerns with the existing tower, its age, the amount of metal lost in its structure, the recoding that needed to be done, and so forth. The cost of that project outweighed the benefits. And so to put money into that tower would have been money not well spent, and it indicated that it was time to build a new tower, either on the same site or another site. So more recently, Bolton and Mink again helped us with a broader water study. And that study looked at the water capacity needs for the city and the pumping capacity and so forth. And it determined that we have the correct amount of water storage at our facilities. So if we were to tear down the Central Water Tower and not rebuild it, we would be behind. If we had a major water usage day, either due to drought or fire or some other reason, we would fall behind and not be able to service the community correctly. So it's important that we replace the tower with another million gallon facility. And there's also some room there for growth. So the city is well positioned in terms of water storage if we replace the existing tower with something similar in size. Multiple different sites around the city were evaluated. Generally, water towers can be placed near areas of high demand, but in our case, for instance, the airport has regulations on how tall a tower can be in those areas, so that precluded some of the sites that we were looking at. Ultimately, the city was designed and laid out with a water tower downtown, and that lays out very well to keep the next water tower downtown. The best benefit to the system is if we rebuild that facility somewhere close to either the Blazing Star Landing or somewhere in the area where it currently exists. One change will be the overflow elevation. The existing water tower at the central location is lower than all of the rest in town. And so the new tower will have a higher overflow elevation so that it matches the others. Water towers work as a reservoir. They sit and bounce depending on the water usage. During high demands, the towers deplete. And during low demands, usually overnight, they fill back up and are ready for you to take your showers or wash your dishes or do laundry, or for our food industries in town to wash down and create business. So again, the goal tonight is really to hear you all, hear your input and your opinions. What we hope is that very soon we'll be able to narrow down to maybe two or three different locations that we can really look closely at from an engineering standpoint, based on feedback from staff, council, and the public, and we can move forward with the design. So these are the three designs that are being recommended by our consultant. The composite structure on the left is the cheapest to build, and cheap, not in a bad way, the least expensive to build. They all have similar service lives, so that we would expect to get 100 years or more out of each of the three options. So just by selecting the cheapest doesn't mean that we're necessarily selecting an option that isn't going to last as long or perform as well. The concrete pillar of this water tower does not need to be painted, so it has less expensive overall maintenance cost over the 100 years that we expect to get out of the tower. But the top of the tower, the tank portion, is steel, so that needs to be coated inside and out every 20 to 25 years. That's where the majority of the maintenance costs come for water towers. The hydro pillar located in the center of the slide has the most steel. So it is the most expensive to build, and it's the most expensive to maintain over the course of the life of the tower. The spheroid tower on the right is about the same as the composite to build, so very similar, but falls in the middle as far as long-term maintenance costs between the composite and hydro pillar. So the least expensive overall is the composite, the most expensive overall is the hydro pillar, and the spheroid lands somewhere in between, a little bit closer to the composite. The next slide is a rendering of what the composite structure might look against the skyline of the downtown. This would be shown if the tower was to be replaced at the current site. We didn't do this rendering for all of the different sites, just the current one. And this is a night shot, but you can kind of get an idea of what it would look like downtown. This would be the hydro pillar. A little bit more massive on the pillar portion of the tower, but similar at the top. And this tower would all be painted, so it would all be white or whatever color we picked for the tower, whereas the composite in this slide, that bottom will remain gray. That would never be painted, so you'd essentially have a two-tone tower with the bottom of it being that concrete color. And this would be the spheroid design. We currently have a spheroid in town. The Home Depot water tower is this same shape. It's a very modern looking shape and performs very well. The proportions of this tower are a little different than the one at Home Depot. It's a much larger tower. The tower at Home Depot, I believe, is 500,000 gallons, and this one would be 1,000,000 gallons. So the base is bigger, the tank, the reservoir area is bigger. So that's why it's not gonna look exactly like the spheroid in this picture, because this is a much smaller tower. This would maybe be a 100,000 or 150,000 gallon tower. Okay. Now we'll move on to tower placement. We identified many different locations in the downtown area that the tower could be constructed. We looked at any site that was open without a building on it, which that's why there are a lot of parking lots shown. There's also a couple of park spaces. And really, the things that factored into evaluating these from a staff standpoint was the proximity to water main, because the water tower has to be connected to the water main, the existing water system. If it's further away from large diameter pipe, we have more pipe to install to get it connected. Relative elevation, the higher the tower is, the shorter we have to build it. Excuse me. The higher the land is, the lower we have to build the tower. So if we build it on a hill, it doesn't have to be as tall as if we built it in a hole. Ultimately though, when you look at the tower being a fixture in our downtown over the course of 100 years, that cost difference in height, we don't feel is going to be a major determinant in where we pick for the tower location. Even the lowest locations that we've evaluated are economically feasible compared to the higher portions, but it is a little bit cheaper. The numbers that you see on the screen are overall rankings. You'll see there's more than 1-2, there's more than 1-3. From a staff standpoint, it makes a lot of sense to replace the tower in its existing location based on the infrastructure that's in place and the area that's allowed. Many of these construction sites involve the displacement of parking, downtown parking. Because we'll be demolishing the existing tower and building a new one, that parking at that location will shift. There will be slightly less at that site. But that was another reason that staff elected to give that a number one ranking, because it would have a lower overall impact to parking and that infrastructure is available. I'm gonna be going through each of these sites individually, briefly with a few comments. There's a range of opinions on each site, and I don't mean to pick out only positives or only negatives on either, but these are just some of the things that we'd like you to consider when looking at the sites. The only site that's not in the downtown location would be the Blazing Star Landing, and I'll discuss that one in more detail once I get to that slide. So the first one that I would talk about would be the existing location. We've more or less eliminated the location with the number 4 on it. The existing tower site, we would move the tower south up the hill closer to the existing building that's there, and the old tower would remain in service during the construction of the new tower, and then the old tower would be demolished. There's existing facilities on site, such as the existing well and treatment plant, where we add chemicals to the water that we pump out of the ground. One of the things that has been brought up is, you know, this is a site with a high value for development. It's right on the lake. It's very visible. A lot of cars that drive by. And it's important to note, if we were to develop this property, the existing well house would be a barrier to that development. We would have to move the well house, drill a new well, install new treatment equipment, and so forth. And those development costs would be absorbed or be a consequence of whatever commercial business or housing or anything like that that we were to put on that property. And that might be a barrier, okay? So it's not just a matter of taking the tower down. There's other facilities at that site that are extremely important and expensive to replace, and that needs to be considered as well. Like I said, it'll have a low parking impact. You know, the existing water tower is featured in a lot of photos. It's very iconic to our downtown. It adds ambiance and character. And so replacing a tower at that location or other downtown locations, because it would certainly be visible in the skyline, you know, keeps that iconic look to our downtown. It certainly has the opportunity, especially if we pick a design that the public feels is aesthetically pleasing, that it can be an asset and not a black eye. You know, that another ugly water tower. Well, there's beauty there too. Another location that we evaluated was at the corner of Washington Avenue and Water Street. This would be right behind the Marion Ross building. Some people call it the Jake's Pizza parking lot. This would have a relatively short distance to connect to the existing water system. Parking could shift. The lot is heavily used, but the parking could shift to the North Broadway parking lot or other on-street parking. And the tower would be very visible when viewing the downtown from afar, similar to the current water tower. The next site is at the corner of Pearl Street and South Broadway. This is right across from the Government Center, and it's currently being used as a parking lot, a gravel parking lot. I think many county employees or citizens using the Government Center use this lot on a daily basis. There are parking opportunities to replace that lost parking on Pearl Street. We could make that a one-way and do diagonal parking and pick up those lost stalls there. This site also has a high elevation, so it'd be a little bit shorter tower to build, and also would be very visible. You know, you essentially guide yourself into downtown because you could see that tower from a long ways away. The Blazing Star Landing site is a site, obviously, that has a lot of history in Albert Lea. This site has a great benefit because it would involve no downtown parking impacts. The tower is shown at a location right off of Garfield, but it would probably be located in the northernmost portion of the site. It would have minimal impacts to development and wouldn't negatively impact the value of the property. So it's a little bit higher ground on the north side. It's right along the major roadway. And it wouldn't, you know, cut up the parcel and make it more difficult to develop in the future. And there's also water main relatively close. We don't have to tear up a road to get to it and so forth. So that's a very viable location. These two locations are parking lots. One is next to the Eagles Club, and one is behind the Department of Human Services building off of William Street and St. Mary. These would obviously involve displacement of parking, but there is ample on-street parking available on William Street, a little bit further away from the primary parking generators. And it seems low, and it is low, but it's actually about the same elevation as the existing site. So we're not losing anything in terms of elevation if we were to move to this point. This site is at the corner of Main Street and Washington. This parking lot is heavily used during special events or evenings, but generally lower usage during the daytime. There are some dedicated parking stalls in this parking lot dedicated to area businesses. We would be able to construct the tower in this location and save that dedicated parking and not have to find those stalls elsewhere. And again, a little bit higher elevation than the previous locations, so very viable. This location is the North Broadway parking lot or park area right next to the splash pad. If you visit our website, I believe the graphic still shows the water tower being located over the parking surface. That is an option, but again, the North Broadway parking lot is really a launching pad for a lot of community events. It's very heavily used, it's a centerpiece, and so shifting the water tower and sparing the parking into the green space is also an option, and that's the way this graphic is shown. There would be some additional work necessary because the water main next to this location is small. We would have to dig down the block further to get to larger water main. But the splash pad would be shaded for much of the late afternoon and evening hours, which would be an unfortunate consequence. People do seek shade at the splash pad, but usually the water goers, the ones that are out in the splash pad, they want to have the sun. So that would be a consequence of this location. And this parking lot is at the corner of College Street and Newton. It's right across from U.S. Bank and Wells Fargo Bank. It is a parking lot that's used very heavily during working days for the government center staff and the bank staff. We showed it here because there's limited space available to the south side of College. There's a smaller parking lot is owned by the county. That could also be evaluated, and in fact, there might be enough room for the tower at that location, but for the purposes of this graphic, we did show it on the larger of the two lots. Again, either of these two, a nice high location, centrally located to the downtown, and easily connected to the existing water main. I think we have one more. So Central Park, is a cherished park. It has a lot of history in Elbert Lee. It's a full block of wide open area. We felt like we had to at least look at it as an option. Obviously, very difficult sell to the public and the community. Most people would argue that we don't want a water tower in Central Park. I understand that. There are some cool things that could maybe be done in terms of a tunnel or something that you could walk through or under. I'm picturing like the Mighty Cedars out in California or something like that. It would be very unique, would change the park dramatically. It would destroy the park for a year or two while we built the tower and cleaned it all up. But again, it's an open space in the downtown area. We thought that it needed to be evaluated. It's number four for a reason, because it ranks very low. But if you had opinions of wanting a water tower there, for sure, let us know. So I went through a lot of information very quickly. Let me just check my notes real quick to make sure that I got through everything. I think I did. Now, as I had time set aside for questions from the group, if you have any questions or concerns, you can certainly air them now. Again, the presentation is being recorded, so I'll try and repeat your question as best I can, and then either Steve or I will answer it. Yes?
The main one here now, is that going to affect the flyway that you'd have?
The question is would the rebuilding it at the central tower location at a higher elevation affect the airport? And that answer is no. We're far enough away from the airport where the glide paths are not close enough to the water tower to affect that, so we would avoid airport impacts at any of the downtown locations.
What is the height that has to be raised?
The new tower would be about 45 feet higher than the existing tower. I meant to mention that earlier. Thank you. All of the other water tower overflow elevations are within a foot or two of each other. And the central water tower right now is about 45 feet lower in terms of overflow. Other questions? Yes.
Are there any engineering or financial negatives to the Central Park location, or is it purely the public opinion history?
The question is are there any engineering or financial pros or cons to the Central Park location, or is it just public opinion? Did I capture the question correctly?
Sure.
From an engineering standpoint, the site lays out rather well. There's water main on three sides, so it would have easy connection. The tower could be orientated right in the middle. It could be located on the north side, east side, west side, however we wanted to do it. But I believe that the biggest barrier to that site would be the public perception. When the high school was there, obviously the park, I think, was probably more heavily used and a lot more pedestrian traffic through it. However, there is common special event applications and things going on in the park. The churches make use of it often. And I think that would be a major concern for many of our citizens. Yes?
Why are you even considering any place but where it belongs, right down here in the corner?
The reality is, the question is why are we considering other locations other than where it is currently located? First of all, there is in place facilities at the existing site that we would lose or go away from if we went to a different site. However, in the grand scope of the project, those are very small, and so we wanted to make sure that we weren't being, close-sighted in our site selection. So we didn't want to miss an opportunity to put it maybe another site. So we felt that it was important to have the consultant evaluate other opportunities, quite frankly, to make sure we weren't missing something. The water tower does not have to be located near the well. Currently, it's on the same site as the well, but moving the water tower alone doesn't mean we would have to drill a new well at a different site. The well and water tower don't have to be in the same area. Did I answer your question, Joe?
No, it belongs right down there where it's at. It's a landmark. It's a city landmark.
So the comment is that it's a city landmark. It belongs right where it is, and basically, we maybe are wasting our time in looking for other opportunities, and that's shared by other people. I understand.
I would like to see it stay where it is because I think it looks nice. If you put it on a hill, it's going to be way up here. But if you have it where it is, you could still raise it, but it's not going to be out of proportion to anything.
Sure.
And Central Park is a no-no as far as I'm concerned, simply because I'm old enough to remember when it was across from the school and it's by the churches. And I went to an event there from First Lutheran, so I would like to just leave that one alone.
Okay, other comments? Yep.
I have a comment, and I'm the youngest person here. I'm going to have to live with this water tower. And the sentiment that however, our National Register of Historic Places mock-ups of this water tower, another 40 town that is largely 1880s. I think that this very greatly detracts from the aesthetics of our. My preference for this, I believe it's an absolute no-brainer to have this at the Blazing Star. Impacts on the downtown, parking impacts. Our downtown really is our culture. Although I appreciate and hearing people who are, I would be devastated to see this.
Yeah, you've got a cell phone tower right over here. That's okay. That doesn't distract.
I didn't say anything about that. This is not the forum.
The rest of us would like to know too.
So you, very well said. I will not be able to capture the essence of your comment, but thank you for speaking on that. Really, the comment was had the nature of we have a very important downtown historic district. Locating the water tower anywhere in the downtown area and having that in the skyline would be a detriment, and that your preference would be to place the tower at the Blazing Star Landing. So thank you very much. Yes?
If you take the old water tower down, are you thinking about making that a parking place, or is that going to be green space?
If the water tower was to be rebuilt on the same site and we were to demo the existing tower, the area would likely be converted to parking to make up for the lost stalls of the new tower. If we built somewhere else, that would be a decision that the city would have to make. You know, do we leave the tower space, the existing tower space, green space, or do we add more parking? That we quite honestly haven't thought much about. Yeah, we would have an option there, though. We'd have a decision to make.
Aesthetically pleasing or anything, it's a necessity. So my feeling is, yeah, I'd like it at the Blazing Star or away from our beautiful lakes. When you drive down Fountain or you drive down Newton, you drive any of those, I mean, we have that jewel. I mean, this is, not very many communities have what we have. And then to see something, it's needed, it's a water tower, you have to have it, but I don't think it does a darn. And even a brand new umpteen million dollar one isn't, I feel, suited somewhere like out of town or away.
Mm-hmm. So the essence of the comment was that the existing tower obviously looks very fatigued. It's not bright and white anymore. And some people love the look and character of the old tower with the structural steel and stuff showing. Other people think it looks busy and distracted and don't like it. And there's a range of opinion in all of that. I certainly appreciate that. But that you think the water tower should be located away from the downtown.
And if that doesn't work, then my second choice, fire station, where we're already building something.
Sure. The College Street location, possibly. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, another question. If we're able to turn that space,
I could take a measurement for you online after the presentation, but I don't know that off the top of my head. But I could find that for you easily.
I appreciate that.
Yep. The question was the amount of green space that could be gained or added from the existing central water tower. If we remove the water tower, how much green space would that add?
70 by 70.
70 by 70 is the approximate area. Councilor Holland?
Bill, you mentioned the shade on the North Broadway parking lot block. So that would only be right near in the evening, right? Like, do you have any sort of signs behind what kind of shade or where that would project?
Yep. The question is how much shade would be projected onto the splash pad during the evening hours. I have not done the geometrics on it yet.
Yeah.
I just saw that, quite frankly, when the 4th of July parade came through and when I had younger kids, we always sought out the shade of the existing central tower to watch the parade in. And that's what made me think of it as, oh my gosh. You
there
know.
Are trees there to the west right now. So I mean,
yep.
I'm sure they put shade on the splash pad as well, right?
Yep. During the heat of the day, like in the 3 o'clock hour, 2, 3, 4 o'clock hour, I think people are looking for more shade in that area. But you know, we keep the splash pad open until I believe 8 p.m. And at that point, you know, it might be the pedestal of the tower that's providing the shade. I don't know how it would exactly be arranged. Well, again, I think go ahead, Paul.
If you're talking 100 years, that site there with some other land around it is probably developable could make a nice site for a hotel or something. But you'd have to use, they'd take some other buildings, but 100 years from now, many of these buildings are not going to be done in the downtown area. But the water tower is always going to be there.
Okay, so 100 years might justify redevelopment of that area into something else other than a water tower site, and that the existing buildings and existing uses are going to change over the next 100 years. Thank you. Okay. I think we're winding down. We will be here until 7 o'clock, so we have another 30 minutes for any of you to ask additional questions or continue your voting. If you run into others and they want to provide input, you can have them contact either the engineering department or the city garage, and we'd be happy to discuss any of the information that we presented here tonight, or you know, take notes and provide input to the council. So again, thank you very, very much for coming tonight. I'm blown away by the attendance. Was there one more thing that you wanted to add? Sure, yep. So the intent was that everybody could make one vote on their preferred style of tower over here on the side, and then you could vote for as many as three locations up here on the tables. There's also sticky notes where if you had a general comment about a tower style or about one of the locations, you could just write your note on one of those stickies and plop it on. You know, if you were adamant against or for or had questions or other comments, you could just do that on a sticky note, and we'll make sure that the council gets that. And just one more aside.
Did I address the development of that?
Okay. Again, if there's any other questions or comments, please talk to one of the counselors or us as staff. Thank you again for coming.